Let me just very briefly tell you what are the seven levels. Yeah? These seven levels, or the seven rows of the periodic table, can be compared to seven levels of human development. Yeah? From conception, or from birth, or from having, I would say, no boundaries, or from being part of the universe, to differentiating oneself more and more, that means developing more and more boundaries, till finally merging back again into the universe. So you could compare it to seven stages of development, from conception to death. I would like to say, and this is the best until now that we have understood it, that these are seven levels of development, from having no boundaries to having stronger, clearer, well-differentiated boundaries, to finally having no boundaries again, or rather, to finally having disintegrated boundaries. So in a way, the seven levels are not a very linear way of progression, but it's a more circular, or a more, I would say, spiral way of progression, where though in the seventh level you merge back with the boundaries, there's much more realization, there's much more awareness, yeah, and there's much more substance than in the beginning, when you are within the boundaries and when you're undifferentiated. So level one is that stage of human development which could be compared to conception. It could be compared to having almost that first point, yeah, where the sperm meets the ovum, or that first point of conception, where a new energy comes into the universe. Or it's that first level, is that point of having no boundaries, or that point where you're still part of the universe and you're not in differentiated soul, you're just going to be that. It's that fine line between nothing to something, or between everything to something, because nothing and everything is the same. So the first level is almost having no boundary. So people in the first level, let's put it like that, are people who find it very difficult to be grounded on this earth. Yeah, they can appear lost. They can not just appear, but they can feel lost, spaced out, or that they don't belong here, or that they cannot incarnate, or that they do not have a ground here, you know, or that they are doubtful whether to exist here or not. This kind of I think it's a very good level for several psychiatric cases, and a level for states that are extremely, extremely confused and do not want to be grounded, or do not want to manifest themselves in this world. So it's a level of, I would say, no boundaries. Yeah, that's how Sachindra and I, we've put it. The second level is the level of human development which can be compared to, let's say, a fetus in the womb, which knows that it is independent. I mean, it's a separate life, but not really, not until it comes out of the womb. So it still has to make that separation, it still has to make that journey to become independent, or it still has to figure out whether it's viable by itself on its own. So the second level, I call it as within boundaries. So the second level, I call it as within boundaries. people, so when you look at people from the second level, then they are people who are very unsure of themselves, who are extremely clingy to others because they are still within the boundaries of others. They don't know if they can have their own boundaries. They don't know if they can have their own independent existence. Or there are people who are working hard for their own boundaries or their own independent existence. So they could be either very clingy, very vulnerable, very fragile people, or people who are trying to overcome their vulnerability, fragility, their such a state of dire dependence. That is the third level, which is the level of finding boundaries or making one's own boundaries. So if you compare it to stages of human development, you have conception, then you have the fetal stage, and then the next is the, not just the fetal, the second one has the fetal as well as the infantile stage. It's that separation from the womb. Yes? Whereas the third level is more the, I would say, the toddler stage. And it's the stage, when you look at the toddler, he's trying to find himself. He's trying to find his place in the society. He's trying to find his place in the family. He's trying to find his personality. He's trying to develop his personality. Meaning, he's trying to develop his ego. He's trying to develop his boundaries. Who am I? What am I? What do I like? What do I dislike? Who are my people? Who are strangers? Who are people I can trust? Who are people I cannot? How do I communicate? Who are the people who accept me? Who are the people who reject me? Can I exchange with these people? Are they exchanging with me? So level 3 is generally about people who need relationships, who are looking for their place in society, who are looking for their place in the family, who are trying to find out what they want, who they are, what their personality is, how much they are loved, how much they are cared. These are also people who love and care in return, because only when you love and care in return will you get it. Yeah? So exchange, communication, relationships, family, my thoughts, my choices, these all make my boundaries, or these all help me define my boundaries. So that's level 3. It's literally the toddler to teenager level, where you start as a toddler to the left of the level, if you now look at the periodic table, and then you go to almost teenage by the end of that level. Yeah? So I'm going through the 18 columns here. The next level, beyond the toddler level, is the level of the young adult. Or level 4, level 3 was defining, finding, making boundaries. Level 4 is about securing boundaries. So it's about sustaining, it's about providing, it's about gathering, it's about building, it's about making a structure. It's about strengthening and securing your boundaries. So in this level of development, the person is not thinking about who I am or what I am, but what can I do? How much can I do? How strong I am? How can I protect who I am? How can I protect my values? How can I protect myself? How can I withstand, yeah, the attack from the outside or the invasions from the outside? This is me. Now I need to make this stronger. I need to make this stable so that it can stand well grounded, well strong. So it's about securing boundaries. And how will you do that? By providing yourself, by keeping yourself strong. So people in level 4 are often thinking about money, bank balance, security, good house, strong house. You know, they're thinking of providing, storing. These are the kind of features that you will see in the fourth level. But once you have secured boundaries, The fifth level is about exploring boundaries. It's about going beyond the boundaries that you made. You found your boundaries, you secured them. Now you want to do something else. You want to make it, you want to look beyond it. You want to stretch your boundary and you want to see what else can you do? How further can you grow? How further can you evolve? That's level five. So people in this level are people who like to explore, who like to learn new things, who are always looking for something new, for newer experiences, for newer adventures, for travel, wanting to upgrade or, you know, upscale themselves from where they are. So adventure and courage is a very important theme of the fifth level. Then the sixth level is about expanding boundaries, yeah, and engulfing the others within your boundaries. Because you made your boundaries in level 3, you found your boundaries, you secured them in level 4, you stretched beyond them in level 5. Level 6, you say, I expand my boundaries, I don't go beyond it, but I engulf everyone else and I expand my boundaries such that everything else is bigger. Or rather, I am bigger than everything and everyone else. So, in other words, the ego is also maximum in the sixth level. So here are people in level 6 who are very responsible about others, who are extremely, responsible and thinking about what others like and what others need. So they have this leadership kind of a quality, this father figure kind of a quality. They feel that everybody else needs to be taken care of. They kind of feel that they need to guide, they need to lead, they need to be the epicenter of everyone around. And that the world revolves around them, or that nothing will happen if they are not around. Something like this almost. They also need to be in charge of themselves completely. They need to have full control of themselves, so they would not like anybody else controlling them at all. So level 6 is about expanding boundaries. People in this level also talk about strength, power, guilt, responsibility, leading. And then comes the level 7, which is merging or disintegrating boundaries, where, you know, you've gone through everything that you could. And then, I mean, how much more can you expand? If you expand any more, then you're going to become the universe itself, from where it all started. So the boundaries begin to now disintegrate and merge back into the universe. So here is, I would say, people who are, or who used to be strong, but have now given in to something more stronger, maybe the will of the universe. So they have traveled through the entire journey of making, securing, going beyond boundaries, and now they are slowly realizing the futility, in a way, or realizing that they need to now merge back in, and disintegrate their own boundaries and merge with something more bigger. So that's more the seventh level. So this is just an idea of the seven levels of human development before we go into the numbers that we have given to various animals in our invertebrate chart, as well as in the mammal book, where we've put the mammal stages in the end. They will come in the bird book. So this was just a glimpse before we go into all the different numbers now in trying to find the pattern of the human being.